Hello everyone, thanks for joining in. And today I have something brand new. I saw at Azure, a website is about something in public review. It's called Ueba for user behavior analytics. And now they have announced it. And I believe it's in public review or preview. And user and entity behavior analytics basically give you the meaningful insight about a particular user. And I'm logged in, as you can see on my screen, where it has an option to configure it. So it's the very first time I just saw it. So I'm just thinking to put a video together. So I'm not sure. You know, as we go, we learn what's there, because first time I'm setting it up, this brand new feature. And here, only global administrator or security administrator in your organization can turn this feature on and off. So there are some prerequisites. So I'm logged in as an administrator here on my tenant. So I should not have any problem. But here, if you look at what permissions available, and you can set it up. And it's about how Microsoft is using your data. So this is important because data privacy is important. And then you need to go and deal or read more details about data protection addendum. Because depending on the size of the organization, your tenant is set up. So in this lab, or in this setup, particular setup, I have everything US based. So I do not have any issue, but it's a setup you have across different countries, depending how your log analytics is set up, your SIEM is set up. You may have to pay attention to that. So we'll just go and enable it. But in the meantime, I clicked on that feature for the settings and everything, so which I was thinking, but I think we can go back and simply enable it. So as soon as I come back, here's an option to enable it, and I'm gonna go enable and see what happens, because as I said, I do have permissions. I should not have any problem. So now turn on the Ueba feature to sync Azure Sentinel with Active Directory, creating profiles for the user and entities in your organization. So you may have to do some work here. Here only a global administrator or security admin, so I'll turn it on. Then here I'll have to select the data sources, okay, which is very important. So audit logs and sign in logs. So basically, if you go and take a look in my previous video about Azure Security Center and Azure Sentinel SIEM, I covered that portion already, where we talk about, you know, sign in logs and audit logs, which pulls from the Azure AD, and also work in even in hybrid environment, based on the setup you may have. But here, without anything, you know, don't see any issue, and you should be able to find. And here it says after the connection, data source will be able to enable them for entity behavior analytics. So it's telling about once you enable it, it will start just to the analytics and on that. So what I'm going to do is that apply now. And it may take some time, and then we will see how soon or when this will be available, is updated. So before I go there, here are some permissions again, how do they use the data and everything. So few seconds ago, so it will take some time, and then We'll see what kind of data is going to pull up. And if I come back home, Sentinel, my tenant, entity behavior. So as you can see, we have this entity behavior, but I don't think so. I'll have the data available right after. But maybe it looks like it. Let's go on the overview. But again, that I was not looking for. So there is some information available. Let's have a look. So this seems to be something new, I believe, from this option, investigate, if I want to do investigation here. And then 90 plus admin activity performed. So what are those activities which I don't know? So I'm gonna click on all those 90 activities and hopefully it will give me the data. So today is September 6th. So these things are performed basically as I'm doing it. You can see it. The things in action perform, but again, I don't want to have any alert for such activities. But if there were some activities done in those dates, which I have not worked any admin activities, then those could be suspicious. And this is what you can start looking into that. So I'll be covering more, but again, just I wanted to give you a very high level since I see this today in my environment and just wanted to see how simple it is to set it up, and then you can start. So I'll find more stuff and more data, and then maybe in my future videos I'll add some more. Thanks for watching and bye.